candy. That's a good one. I was excited, guys, to be here this morning to talk to you. It's funny because Chief Waters and I are very good friends. We used to be neighbors. Taught his son basketball. There's a lot of folks in the building. I met Dane. He's known me for years, teaching basketball and working with kids. So it's kind of exciting to be here this morning. But listening to what they said, I kind of going to shift a little bit to give you a little bit more of what I wanted to give you them from the beginning. Because they talked about conditioning. She just brought up the idea of generations. And we talk about how they've been programmed. And you're here today because they're trying to expose you to something different. They're trying to show you what the opportunity of life can be. Now, my name is Grayson Marshall, Jr. I'm from Washington, D.C., born and raised. I'm married with four kids, four grandkids. I was an All-American at Clemson. I still hold 13 collegiate records. I'm in the Clemson University Hall of Fame. I'm an ACC basketball legend. And I was homeless at 29 years old. And I say that so that you can understand that when I'm talking to you, I'm being real. I've got a few minutes before you, so I want to give you as much as I can give you in this short period of time. Now, I wasn't homeless because I wasn't smart. Because I think if you listen to me talk, you can understand that I'm by no means uneducated. But I was homeless because the plan that school gave me was not sufficient enough for me to go out and succeed in the world the way that I wanted to. My mother was a principal, my dad was a teacher, my sister's actually the head of online education for the Department of Defense, so academics was never an issue. But when I got into the world, I realized that I did everything he told me to do, degree and everything, and I found out when I got in the world that that degree did not mean exactly what they said it did. Now, you need to get one, no two ways about it, because the world is going to ask you for one, and you need to be credentialed to do the things that you do. However, you have to get a supplemental education, you have to learn, which is why kids seem to drift towards gangs because they're getting some different information. That's why it's important for us to give you information to counter that. So I'm going to talk to you about that today. Here's what I know. If I can change your thoughts, I can change your beliefs. If I can change your beliefs, I can change your level of expectation. If I can change your level of expectation, I can change your attitude. If I can change your attitude, I can change your behavior. If I can change your behavior, I can change your performance. And if I can change your performance, I can change your life. But it all starts with the way you think. My favorite book says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. I want to talk to you today about the way that you think, because we don't realize how easy we're programmed. Now, I've got one of my books here, and I'm going to give it to somebody, but I need somebody out here who can help me. Which one of you all can spell? I need somebody who can spell. All right, come on. She was the first one. Come on up. Give her a hand real quick. Now, I want none of you all to help her, because I asked how many of y'all can spell, now how many of y'all can really spell? All of you can. Watch this. Here's what I want you to know. You didn't raise your hand because you were fearful of what I might do. And let me tell you something. That is the way that you're going to enter into the world, and that's the way you're not going to succeed. See, the one thing I do when I go around the country, you know, whether it's corporate or kids, I talk to them real. The reason you're not where you are, the reason you're not where you want to be, the reason you're hesitant about doing the things you do, I don't care what age you are, is because fear sets in and it's greater than your faith. So she was the first one to put her hand up. All right, now, here's what I want to do. It's real simple, okay? You all right? Yeah. You want up here. You wrong? I said, who can spell? All y'all willing to do? All right, so you ready? Okay, so here we go. We're going to do something called the MAC test. Okay, come stand right here. All right, this is called the MAC test, okay? I'm going to spell words that begin with the letters M-A-C. Say MAC. Mac. Okay, y'all say Mac.
Mac.
Now, don't help her from here on out. Okay, now, I'm going to spell the word. I'm going to spell the word, and I want you to tell me what the word is. Real simple. Okay. First word. M-A-C-D-O-N-A-L-D. McDonald. Very good. Very good. M-A-C-D-U-F-F. McDuff. M-A-C-B-R-I-D-E. McBride. M-A-C-H-I-N-E-S. McHenness. M-A-C-H-I-N-E-S. 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 Somebody loud over there. Who did? Okay, watch it. Hold on. Now, what's M-A-C-H-I-N-E-S spell? Machines. Now watch this. Hold on. How many adults? Tell the truth, shame the devil, says something outside of machines. Raise your hand. Thank you. Thank you. Now watch it. Even the CEO said it. Here's what I'm telling you. Listen to me, kids. Listen to me, adults. If I can reprogram you in 30 seconds, what can 30 years of bad programming do for you? 40 years of bad programming. And here's the reality. If I had written it on the board, how many of y'all would be able to spell it? Everybody. So, kids, don't tell me what you listen to in music don't affect you.
Right.
Don't tell me that. Give her a book. I've done that as long as I've been speaking. I think one time in the 20 years I've been speaking, somebody got it right. And here's why. It's not that you can't spell. It's because you're programmed a certain way. And it will affect you. It affects your decision making. So the smartest kids in the world can get stuck in the wrong stuff. There's no blueprint for success other than you have to really control this thing right here. This is the largest receiver and information giver on the planet. Yet we don't know how to control it. We don't know how to structure it. We don't know how to speak to it, but it can speak to us. And I do that, sweetie, not to embarrass anybody. I do that to show you how easy it is to get led the wrong way. It doesn't take much and it doesn't take long. So what I want to do today is I want to give you four things that you can think about. And they're called the Four Agreements. They're from a book by Don Miguel Ruiz. It's called the Four Agreements. And I use it when I'm talking to younger audiences because I want to give them a foundational platform that they can be personally accountable. Say personally accountable. I'm going to give you some bands before you leave to say it's on me. Why? Because your life and your success is on you. It's on me. So I'm going to give you four things. Say four.
Four.
I'm going to give you four things that you can do, that you can be personally responsible for to help you move to the next level. It's not just for kids, it's for adults too. It's in the work. Number one, first thing you can do is be impeccable with your words. Say that. Be impeccable.
Be impeccable.
With your words.
With your words.
Now what does that mean? Be impeccable with your words comes from the Latin word peccatos, which means sin. So we're talking about being impeccable with our words. It's basically saying, mean what you say and say what you mean. I've got to do what I say I'm going to do. I've got to be clear. When I'm talking about impeccable, being real refined with what I have to say. I've got four kids and four grandkids. I've got to be real clear because for some reason, by the time it leaves my mouth and gets to their ears, it loses translation. And I know I was real clear with what I just said. So I've got to be impeccable with my words. I have to do that. It's important. My mother taught me. God rest her soul. My mother taught me that command of the English language would take me further than anywhere I wanted to go in life. And what I find when I look at your generation, because you're so into technology, you forget how to speak. We stood at the door, and I saw five corporate people greet you all, and we counted 27 of you all walk by and didn't even say hello. Didn't speak. Now, if they'd have Snapchatted you, you would have responded in 2 seconds. Let me tell you something, not a person here in corporate America is talking during Snapchat. I want you to understand that because a lot of times what happens is that we don't want to tell you what's real, and that's not what I do. See, every time I go speak not to be added back. That's the truth. Because half the time I'm busting people in the head and they don't like, don't bring him back here. Especially when I go in churches, boy, they don't like to see me come to church. I mess the church up. Not because I don't love God, it's because I challenge you in your personal responsibility. So be impeccable with your words. It's important. Speaking is powerful. Explain who you are, being able to conversate is important. All that's a part of you becoming who you need to become. So be impeccable with your words. Say impeccable.
Impeccable.
Well, number one. Number two.
Number two.
Don't take anything personal. Say that. Don't take anything personal. Say it again. Don't take anything personal.
Don't take anything personal.
Now, how many of y'all know that's hard as heck for some people? Don't take anything personal. See, what's funny, here's what's funny, and I like to talk to adults and kids at the same time, because what I share with kids, adults can find themselves having to check themselves as well. Don't take anything personal. See, if you get it right now, it's easier as you grow older. Don't take anything personal. If something happens to you, it's not you. Now, you may have caused something to happen. You got to own those. But don't take anything personal. When folk do you wrong, don't take anything personal. Why would you? That's their issue, not mine. But here's what happens. You internalize that, and you take it for what it isn't.
And the reason it's important to me, because I'm 50 years old now, and in 1972, I experienced racism for the first time. And it wasn't from white America. I experienced racism from my own people. Because in 1972, being dark-skinned and African-American was just not it. And it really sat with me for years. Changed who I was a lot. My only saving grace was my athletic ability. I lettered 18 times in high school. So that was the level playing field for me. You could talk about me in person, but you couldn't do anything with me in the sports arena. But it affected me for years and years and years and years and years. Because I took it personal. The reason I'm so adamant and passionate about people changing is because you've got to shift that inside. I travel around now and I speak on a platform called I Was Never Enough Until. And then on a person in the world that has audibly said that at least one time or thought it at one time. Because of a success-driven society, I was never enough until. It becomes achievement-driven. But here's the reality, I was never enough until I learned that I already was. The power behind who you are is who you are inside. And that's what you have to get to go to know. That's what you have to dig down deep into. That's what you have to find. That's why you can't take anything personal. Because when you know who you are, it doesn't matter what they said. So number one, I've got to be impeccable with my words. Number two, I've got to take nothing personal. Number three is make no assumptions. Say, make no assumptions.
Make no assumptions.
We tend to do that no matter what. We assume all kinds of stuff. And assumptions create fear. And here's what you have to understand. 99% of what you have fear of will never happen. It's amazing. But we worry about it. Because we assume this, we assume that. Understand this, you're in control of you and you're all you can control. Make no assumptions. People do have different agendas. Had nothing to do with you. Make no assumptions. Always ask. Again, back to using this. Ask questions. It's important. Get the answers. Know where you're going. But make no assumptions. And the fourth thing is the one I love the most. Number four is always do your best. Say that with me. Always do.
Always do.
Your best.
Your best.
Always do.
Always do.
Your best.
Your best.
That's all you can do. I thought when I was able to resolve that in my spirit, always do your best, and that's all I can do. That's all anybody can ask of you. How many of y'all heard this before? Do 110%. Have I heard that before? That's the craziest thing in the world I've ever heard. How in the world can you do 110%? The most you can do is what? 100. That's all you can do. I hear that all the time. I'm like, what are you telling these people? If there's more left to do, then you're not doing 100. Just know that. That's just, it's amazing to me. And here's the stuff that we hear. How many of y'all heard this before, corporate America? Think outside the box. Well, here's what. Watch this. What did you just admit? That you're in a box. It makes no sense to me. You just admitted you were in one. If you got to think outside of it, that means you're in one. How about this? Think like there is no box. And that's what I found when I walked around here today. This company was amazing to me. It was so refreshing. Because they allow you to think like there is no box. Expand yourself. Grow. The principles, the philosophies that are there. This is why they connected with you all. Because this company is a glimpse of what life should be like. What life could be like. What life can be like. It was amazing to walk through. And I come early on purpose to experience the atmosphere that I'm going to have an opportunity to speak in. It was awesome to walk around and see. And you guys being a little bit late allowed us to do that. It was a blessing to see that. And it was awesome to be able to do that. So those four things are real simple, aren't they?
Yes.
See, life isn't hard unless you make it that way. It may appear to be hard, but I'm telling you, this thing is easy if you want it to be. I'm 50 years old. I don't work for anybody. I own my own companies. My kids run my companies. It's beautiful. I have vested interest. I play golf as much as I feel like it. It's wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. And I get to do this. Why? Because it's what I love to do. I love people. I love seeing them grow. I love the opportunity you have to change somebody's life. And it's awesome. So remember these four things. Number one.
Number one. Oh.
Number one is what?
Be impeccable
in the word. What's number two? Number three? And number four? When you can respond like that with the answers, this is why people aren't gonna let you off easy. See, this is why there's when we know what's in you, we can't not push you. When we know what's in you, we can't not want more from you. When we know what's in you, we can't let you settle. That's why companies like this do what they do. That's why myself and Dr. Gentry do what we do around the country. Because I can't let you settle. I'm no good if you're not better than me. I love God. I'm not ashamed of that in anywhere I go. In John 14 and 12, Jesus said this, "A greater works than these shall you do, because I'm going to be with my Father." He gave us the opportunity to do way more than he ever did. And we're no good unless we offer you that same thing. I can't document my legacy if I don't give you more to pass me. There's nobody good enough if somebody behind them isn't better. It's your job to take everything you learn, take everything that's taught to you, own it, grow it, and give it to somebody else. If you want to change your neighborhood, if you want to change your school, if you want to change the people that you're around, that's what you have to do. You got to own it, grow it, and give it away. I'll leave you with this. Today I'll touch 1,000 lives before the day is done. Leave countless marks of goods and ill ere set the evening sun. This is my wish, I always wish, my prayer, I always pray. Lord, let my life touch 1,000 lives before I'm called away. I negotiated with life for a penny, and I found out to my dismay that whatever wage I would have asked life for, life was surely a pay. That once was a very cautious man who never laughed or played. He never tried, he never took a risk, he never sang a prayer. And then one day that man, he died. His life insurance was denied because they said he never lived. Chance of this thing. Mm-hmm. Chief Waters said he's on his way out, and I'm not. I don't know what he's talking about. But you only got one chance at this thing. I'm just getting started, and you got a lot more time than I have. Make the most of it. God bless you. My name is Grayson Marshall Jr. I'm the guy that makes you feel